In the previous video, we explored some comfyUI workflows to generate images using the SDXL and Flux models. Now, let's look at how to generate an image using a reference image in comfyUI. In this image-to-image generation, I will be using SD 1.5, SDXL, Flux GGUF, and Flux BNB models. You can also use the similar workflow for the Flux 24GB. Make sure to change the GGUF node. I will begin with the SD 1.5 checkpoint, Realistic Vision, which can be downloaded from here. You can see the prefix for Flux and Stable Diffusion models. You can achieve this by creating folders and organizing the models accordingly. The folder name will be visible before the model's name. Now, I need a reference image, which I will obtain from Civit AI. I applied a filter for SD 1.5, and let's assume I found an image I like and want something similar, but with a different touch. I will select the first image from the results. To replicate this, I will copy and paste both a prompt and a negative prompt, and then cue the workflow. Well, the result is not anywhere near the expectation. Let me see what else can be done to improve this. The person here used a different checkpoint, which is named Epic Photo, and the base model is SD 1.5. I will download it and save it inside the checkpoint folder, then the SD 1.5 folder. After downloading, I refreshed the model list by pressing the letter R and selected the downloaded model named Epic Photo. I then tried generating the image again. These are some of the scariest Pikachu images you might have seen. This could represent the actual situation when you want something, but it never turns out as expected, as shown in the tutorials. Our goal is to create a similar image with our personal touch. Let's use the reference image to assist the AI. I will double-click and type load to select the Load Image node. It has a thumbnail from the previous 1.2.1 video I uploaded a week ago. I will download the reference image. Back in comfyUI, I will use the Load Image node to choose the file for upload. Now I have the image in comfyUI. Instead of providing a random latent image as a canvas to the K-sampler, I will use this image so that the new image generated will be based on the reference image I am providing. Please note that while we have given a latent image to the K-sampler, the Load Image node can provide a pixel image and a mask, but neither will work for the K-sampler. I need a converter in between to transform this pixel image into a latent image. This converter is similar to the VA decode node, which takes the latent representation and converts it into a pixel image for us with the help of the VAE from the checkpoint. I will double-click and search for VAE and find something opposite to decode, which is VAE encode. Now the pixel image goes to the VAE encode node, and the output, the latent representation, goes to the K-sampler. The VAE decode node uses the VAE from the checkpoint, so the same VAE will be used for encoding. I hope you have seen the previous video I uploaded, where I explained latent space in simple terms. I tried generating the image, and while it's not an exact match, it's certainly better than the scary Pikachu we saw before. The reason it's still not working as intended is due to the denoising strength. When I set it to 0.10, we got almost a replica of the reference image. At 0.30, it was similar, but a bit different. Setting it to 0.70 kept the posture the same, but it started to take on the angry look we saw earlier. At 0.90, it resulted in a completely different image. So I hope you understand, lowering the denoising strength brings the image closer to the latent representation. To clarify, the image generation process begins with a given image, which exists in latent space filled with noise. Then the noise is gradually removed, revealing the final subject. In our case, we provided an image of our subject, Pikachu. The more noise that is removed, the more it transforms into something else. There are a few details I skipped to keep it simple. If you're interested in learning more, I'm starting a new channel where I will be coding and explaining how it works. I believe keeping the denoising strength around 0.4 or 0.5 will yield good results. In this scenario, I want to generate an image that closely resembles the original, but with a slight changes. So let me add some color, like orange. Then I will select the color section in the prompt and press Ctrl plus Shift and then the up arrow key. This will increase the weight of the selected words in the prompt while generating an image. As a result, we got orange fur on the subject. However, this is just an example, and the orange looks unappealing to me. There is a limit to the weight. Increasing it too much can spoil the image. I recommend keeping the maximum weight at 1.5. I hope you now understand the simple workflow for image-to-image generation. In the prompt, you will see scores and numbers. These are used for better results, as AI models were trained on images that had scores out of 10. The AI models have learned about the images that scored above 7 during the training process. Specifying a score of 7 and above means we want an image similar to those that scored higher than 7. The workflow you are looking at will work for the SDXL Juggernaut model as well. Let me generate an image. The image got changed. The SDXL models are trained on 1024 pixel images, so we should be generating an image somewhere close to 1024 pixel for better results. Here I provided a 512 pixel image as a latent representation. I can increase the size of the given image, which can then be converted into a latent representation. I will search for upscale and select the upscale image node. I will place it between the load image node and the VAE encode node. I will change the size to 1024 pixels, and now the image will be upscaled. I tried generating the image, but it looked like a stuffed toy. I removed the score from the prompt and decreased the denoising strength to 0.20, and then the image looked more similar to the original. In fact, it now resembles Pikachu more than before. The original image leaned a bit towards a cat, but this one does not. I think it looks good. Of course, looks are subjective, and this is SDXL. Let's look at Flux. Now let's look at the Flux GGUF workflow, which is from the last video. The required nodes will remain the same. I will copy the load image node and paste it here, along with the upscale image node. I will provide the 512 pixel image to the upscale node. However, the output from the upscale node cannot be directly given to the case sampler. We need to create a latent representation first. I will copy and paste the VAE encoder node and connect it to the upscaled image. The output goes to the case sampler. The VAE from the load VAE node is also necessary for this process. The workflow should be clear if you have seen the previous video. I will use the prompt kid in Superman's costume and provide the latent image of our subject. The denoising strength is set to 1.0, and as expected, the output image features a kid as per the prompt. When I change the denoising strength from 1.0 to 0.40, I get an image that closely resembles the reference image. A denoising strength of 1.0 removes more noise from the input image, resulting in an image that aligns more closely with the text prompt. After applying the prompt from the previous workflow, the image looks good, and now you know image-to-image generation using the Flux UNet models. Next is the Flux BNB model, which is a checkpoint that combines the clip text encoder and VAE into a single file. I will press Ctrl and click this node to select it, then use Ctrl plus C to copy and paste it here. I will disconnect the empty latent image node and connect the VAE encoder that has the reference image. The BNB model workflow was explained in the previous video, so please watch that if you do not understand this workflow. I will paste the prompt for Pikachu and generate the image. I forgot to select the model, and the encoder does not have the VAE connected, so I will connect the VAE and cue the workflow. The result is a blurry image of Pikachu. By decreasing the denoising strength to 0.5, I got a similar image with better details. I set the denoising strength to 0.7. The output diverges significantly from the reference image. The image here is definitely better than the SDXL model. I think the image-to-image generation is done. I just wanted to provide an update on a previous video where I discussed the larger 24GB Flux 1 dev model. After that, I directly suggested the GGUF model. However, I overlooked the Flux 1 dev FP8 model. This model is designed for those who want to keep things manageable while still getting the best performance from Flux on a 24GB card. It's a 17GB model that I have never used, but perhaps I will upgrade to a larger GPU in the future, making it possible to use. Please let me know if the video was helpful. Should I create more videos on comfyUI explaining nodes? Is anyone interested in learning how to code this using Python?